This morning, convicted cop killer David Sweat is in custody and revealing stunning new information to investigators from his hospital bed. Details on the escape plot he and fellow inmate Richard Matt devised. Authorities say the two men planned a run south of the border with former prison worker Joyce Mitchell.
They would kill Mitchell's husband and then get in the car and drive to Mexico on the theory that Mitchell was in love with one or both of them.
The plot quickly unraveling when Mitchell got cold feet and didn't show up with the getaway car. Now Mitchell speaking out from behind bars. Her lawyer telling ABC News his client is ecstatic, both that the manhunt has ended and also that it appears no harm came to any other person. Sweat also revealing to authorities that prison guard Gene Palmer was not involved in the escape plan. According to officials, the convicted killers seen on this surveillance camera in the woods just last week decided to head towards Canada. For the best part of 3 weeks, the two sticking together, eluding checkpoints and police searches in the dense woods. But Sweat telling officials they separated in the final 5 days because Matt was slowing him down.
Down here, they got him down here.
Matt spending some of his final hours in this abandoned camper before being shot and killed by police on Friday.
You can see how somebody could hide out in here, though.
Yeah, very easily. It's dry and, you know, and would keep you from the elements, at least.
48 hours later, State Police Sergeant Jay Cook spotted Sweat running on a road. Sergeant Cook chasing him, then shooting him twice. Local residents celebrating in the streets, relieved it's finally over.
We can sleep better. We have our town back. We feel great.
A state police source tells ABC News Sweat also told investigators he and Matt had a transistor radio that they would use to listen to news on the manhunt and that Matt was smoking marijuana, slowing them down. Lindsay Janis, ABC News, Malone, New York.